This was in the midst of apartheid. And I wanted to break the apartheid barrier in sport. I could do that. If I went somewhere else, I would have been put in jail. But in sport, it was my life.
It was the first act of a fall of apartheid. He said that all the time.
It was difficult for me, and it was difficult for him. And he came and he played.
It was a lot of places that we played that had never, I was the first African-American to play multiracial sports in South Africa. And it was frightening to the extent that I didn't know what to expect.
He got a lot of media, and we went down to Swaziland, which is our neighboring state, and he went to universities and did a wonderful job, and it was highly successful.
When I accepted a visa, I said that I would not come there to play before a segregated audience, that blacks would be able to come and view my play and also be able to go into the clubhouse and to come without paying, because I knew that they were unable to pay the prices for the tickets to come into the term. That was all granted. It was certainly a trip that I was very proud of.
Here was a man that did something that was far beyond an athletic endeavor. And I've always been so disappointed that Lee Elder has never been given any, just a medal of this to that he could hang and for his children and his family to put in his memoirs forever, and it's never happened. Never happened.